pulling the cards for four cards for persona, shadow, and duality dynamic, and self. Loving can hurt sometimes, but it's the only thing that I know. Pertaining to the sun and moon current location for the overall dominant energy of collective. But the sun in Cancer and the moon is currently in Pisces. With the sun and moon, what we're balancing is the sun, the conscious is in Cancer, unconscious in Aries. Setting true intentions, and unconscious about the demise of hierarchy between submissive and controlling. The heart chakra and root chakra. Root chakra consciously, heart chakra unconsciously. The moon is currently and consciously in Pisces. Solar plexus energy, and the unconscious moon is also solar plexus energy. Center, and it's between Pisces consciously and Scorpio unconsciously, which is about gate 22 and 44. Sweetness of suffering and karmic relationships. Unconsciously about interference and teamwork. So, Pisces energy brings, before I go there, the moon is our instincts, habits, intuition, patterns. It's about how you feel secure and tend to feel insecure, which, pertaining to karmic relationships, is what the theme is for the reading. And it's also, it will pertain to immediate reactions, immediate feelings, involuntary actions, where the sun is about our ego self, our healthy ego, healthy intentions, the like internal parent that runs the show, whereas the moon is like the inner child. So we're kind of balancing that for alignment of how navigation through these things can play into a self-worth tool is kind of what the purpose of the reading is for. And what the current astrological positions are for the sun and moon, consciously and unconsciously, is where how I got the theme. But it's about balancing our like inner child versus our inner parent. And the theme is currently about relationships, karmic relationships, and illuminating the balancing of our how to progress through difficult situations and the importance of planting seeds on what your true intentions are. There is a lot of water energy as well because of Cancer, Pisces, and Scorpio is all water energy. Whereas Aries, which is the unconscious sun, is fire energy. Okay, for first card to fill out with artist, and then we have void. Got two more to go. Duality dynamic, and then self. Oh, there's two. This is how they fill out. So I'm going to do guide and poet. Now, the light and shadow attributes on these cards are the polarity spectrum. It's a spectrum of polarity, so there isn't one absolute versus the other. That's not how it's focused. It's focused based on how to balance between the polarity spectrum. Okay, and on the split, we have the seeker on the bottom, and the split is the alchemist. I'm gonna take a minute to get situated. I'm gonna stop the camera for a minute and get situated. Okay, I'm pulling cards from Archangel deck, tarot deck, but I pulled out just the Major Arcana to for clarification on each of the archetype cards for Persona, the Shadow, the Duality Dynamic, and the Self. We have the Artist, the Bully, the Guide, and the Poet. So the Persona, which is interesting that the Artist and the Poet are the Persona and the Self. Here and here, because the persona being the face we show the world, and the self being ultimately the closest aspect of the collective overall dynamic of aligning and being your true self, basically your core self, where. The shadow and the duality dynamic is shadow came out as the bully, and the duality dynamic as the guide. Okay. Shuffle on the cards. Shuffled them quite a bit, but now complete intention to that. Just do a little bit more. Plan on pulling one card for each one of the archetypes. First one, persona. We have life experience, the Empress, the Dreamer, which is full, and release. This card 16, the life experience, is equivalent to the Tower card in the standard tarot. And the Empress is the Empress. The Dreamer represents the Fool. And card 13, the Release, represents the Death card, which is about new beginnings. New beginnings. Persona. Shadow. Okay. So with the persona, shadow, duality, dynamic, and self, with the sun and the moon topic for the reading, the persona and the self is going to represent more on the sun, whereas the shadow and the duality dynamic is going to represent the side over for the moon. So I'm going to switch these. Okay, so to pull the cards, I started shuffling already. These ones fell out pertaining to, these are clarifying them together. So with clarifying these for the sun and this for the moon. Okay, so I am using the Angels and Ancestors Oracle cards for the, I'm going to pull five cards for the overall dominant energy out of this, and what's being shown, how to shift moving forward, what we've learned, lessons gathered, and how we are ready to move forward. Father Sky, Broken Arrow, Stargazer, She-Wolf, and Magic Guardian. Okay, with the sun and the moon, with the sun consciousness being in the overall collective dominant energy. Sun consciousness in Cancer currently, and the unconsciousness in Aries, the moon consciousness in Pisces, and the moon unconsciousness is in Scorpio, which is water energy, a lot of water energy. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio is all water energy, and Aries is fire energy, and it also represents the fourth house, the eighth house, and the 12th house with all the water energy, whereas the fire energy represents the first house as well. Okay, which what this is saying to me, what I see from this is okay, with all the water energy, water holds memory. Water is vital to life on Earth because many reasons. But water is also the ultimate transformation. Things change. It's also emotion it represents, which also is memory. But water cleans everything, it purifies it. So even with fire energy, if something's destroyed or destructed and it burns down, the regrowth process has to begin with water, washing it all away, cleansing it, okay? Now, the moon is all water energy, the sun is water and fire, okay? Which the unconscious is fire, and it's under the demise of hierarchy, okay? To me, this is talking about unconsciously the overall dominant energy of the collective. Is the things going to work unconsciously, humanity destroying certain foundations that it's okay to let go, to start anew, to transition into a paradigm shift for evolution, for transitioning out of fear-based into more love-based, with balancing of consciousness, with balancing of all of our energies within, with the persona, the shadow, the duality dynamic, and the self, where the persona represents our face, who we present ourselves to be in the world, which is an ego aspect, but it's a healthy ego aspect. Ego is healthy, and it's about, you know, we all, it's like the show, who we are in our life. In our life, the author, who we are playing, who we are, basically, okay? Whereas in the self is your core self integrated. Once you embody your energies correctly, okay? Whereas the shadow is like our rejected self or abandonment self, self-abandonment things, any traumatic things, you know, that need heal. And such. And the duality dynamic is balancing the masculine and feminine energies within ourselves. Okay? And it all starts within ourselves, because we all carry masculine and feminine energies. And our outer world reflects our inner world. And to be able to, and it doesn't mean that we embody them split 50-50. Not like that at all. But however, you know, we have all of the energies, just as we also have all of the zodiac signs within us, not just our sun sign, which is what most of us really only know of, but we carry all 12 signs. The whole point of the zodiac is about learning how to navigate and learning through gaining experience and gaining wisdom out of things. And it's about embodying and incorporating all of the aspects of the zodiac within us to be complete, to have a good life experience, which also incorporates like creative diversity and such of understanding, and about how we use things within us to balance other things. It's about polarity balancing and the spectrum and such, okay? Now, and the duality dynamic is also about balancing structure and creativity within, basically, with the feminine and masculine, what it represents. And I'm not going to go into too much of that right now, but I just wanted to get a little bit of that for the basis of the reading. But with the artist representing the persona and the poet representing the self, and the bully representing the shadow and the guide representing the duality dynamic. Okay, and remember, this is sun and this is representing the moon. Now, what I see for this is, and we also have the, the Tower card and the Death card, representing the energies. For the artist is the Tower, Black Experience, and under the poet is the Death card, which is about transformation. Under the shadow aspect of Bully, we have the Empress, and we have under the Guide, or duality dynamic, the Dreamer, which is also the Fool. Okay. Now, for the Sun, we have the Magician representing the overall energy. Here we go. Okay, here it is. For the Artist and the Poet, and the Two of Pentacles representing the Bully and the Guide for the Moon, which is about juggling. Okay? And it's Earth energy. Okay. Now, with the artist, okay, for the persona, and the poet as the self, we have, it's about expressing the dimensions of life that's just beyond our own five senses, inspiring others to see life symbolically. That's the light attribute, where the shadow attribute is using talents as an excuse to mistreat others, posing as a starving artist to elicit pity, okay? Now, remember, this is the polarity spectrum of the extremes. So the whole thing about archetypes is, for this archetype, this is the extreme of each end of the spectrum, and the whole concept is to be able to balance these things to come out equally. So it's not saying there's heavy one or heavy the other, okay? Whereas the poet, the light attribute, is expressing soul insights in symbolic language, which is itself. And the shadow attribute, polarity spectrum, is about turns a lyric gift into a negative or destructive effect, okay? Which is also about finding the beauty in everything, okay, in everyday life and everyday objects, hidden joys and hidden sorrows, okay. And remember, this is representing the sun, which in astrological right now, within Cancer and Aries, is also representing our intentions, okay, our energetic true intentions and planting seeds, and how what our intentions are planting seeds for whatever comes around next, okay? And also about the demise of the hierarchy of submission and control, which is what the unconscious and conscious sun astrologically is currently representing dynamically for everyday life situations, okay? Of what is being shown and what lessons are kind of being embodied currently, you know, I mean, it shifts, and it's just like the overall dynamic, where with the moon, we have the bully attribute. The light attributes highlight your tendency to intimidate others and helps you confront the inner fears that bully you, which is perfect for shadow, actually, because it's exactly what a shadow is about. And the shadow attribute of this card, which is, I'm talking about shadow because it represents the shadow aspect, okay, of the archetype right now where I have it lined up, where the shadow attribute is concealing deep fears behind verbal or physical abuse, which is about giving in to your fear by lashing out on others, projecting on others, taking things out on others, or enacting things out on others, becoming things that were done to us instead of healing, how you kind of step into that role to feel powerful. Sometimes that's the way people move on in life to feel that they get their power back, is to mistreat others the way they were mistreated, because that makes them feel powerful again. Okay, now the duality dynamic of the guide, the light attribute is about, represents the nature of the divine in life and in yourself, which is about acceptance of what is. Okay, it's the shadow attribute is about placing financial gain and control over imparting spiritual insight. Okay, that is about the duality dynamic. Now, with that, which represents masculine and feminine energies within ourselves, which really, really, to me, what this is saying, especially with this having the Two of Pentacles balancing, okay? The moon is illuminating our shadow and our duality dynamic, things pertaining to the sweetness of suffering, basically. What we do, how we suffer, and how we continue to normalize it, as well as karmic relationships. I didn't mention that yet. But the moon, astrologically, is representing the sweetness of suffering, okay? In the Pisces energy, which is about becoming aware of it, about knowing and understanding our habitual and patterns and such like that, that we contribute to and normalize in our life, that, you know, once you become aware of, you can take control of and change. And it's also representing the unconscious part of the moon astrologically is representing karmic relationships, which is about bringing to light, you know, interferences and ways that we need, that the way karmic things balance out between the shadow and the duality dynamic, and about that is I mean, I don't even know what to say. That's like actually, wow, these cards that came out, I'm not surprised, but and it's about how to transition. Now, the lessons embodied. Now, the things happening astrologically are just lessons, things that are coming to awareness. And it's about progressing and conquering them and overcoming them and transitioning them. So it's not about, hey, this is what is coming along astrologically to make you suffer. That's not what it's about. It's about shedding light on things to be able to overcome them and move in a new direction and change things, okay? And the Scorpio energy is the karmic relationship astrological energy, and that's about transformation, and that's about energy balancing. That's about how we exchange energy with others, and how it's a lot about transforming the shadow. The eighth house, Scorpio, and such represents transforming things and embodying growth within us to progress with things that are illuminated, where we look within ourselves to see what our part is in something to change things, okay? Which, with Aries being the only fire sign, that also represents the first house, which is new beginnings, which represents where the unconscious is coming around, representing changing, shifting it around, starting new, igniting your flame, igniting your fire, basically, onto what it is, you know, that can help us change our thought processes. What can help us balance our consciousness and our intentions on what we put out there, and planting new seeds. Because whatever you do today, and the little seeds you put in intentions, and anything that you do, everything we do represents us. And even if we do it and we think nobody's watching, or nobody, you know, those things hinder our own self. Ultimately, all that does is come around and hinders ourself, because it doesn't matter if no one knows or whatever. It comes around, what goes around comes around, and it will full circle around whatever those intentions are. Those are us planting seeds all the time. And if we plant bad seeds, things are going to come back around, and the intentions, whatever you put out, is what's going to come back. It's not going to grow and form into whatever it is that, you know, abundance or prosperity or inner happiness or fulfillment. If you're not sending out into the world things with your intentions and planting those seeds in the right way for you, you're not going to get things back in the right way for you, okay? And the Two of Pentacles is representing the bully and the guide, which is the shadow and the duality dynamic, about juggling how to handle these things, okay? And the Magician is representing the persona and the self, with the artist and the poet. And to me, this is talking about, with the persona and the self, the artist and the poet, it's talking about our creative expression, how we represent ourselves, and our words, and what we choose to use, and how we choose to see things. Like with creative diversity, what you send out comes back. Now with the poet and the artist together, this is just perfect, actually. And the Magician is about manifesting. It's about using what you have and creating something with your intentions correctly, utilizing all of the elements, earth, fire, water, water, and air. Oh my goodness, I could not think of air for some reason for a second. Sorry about that. So earth, fire, water, and air. Oh, actually, poet, words, air. Okay, totally explains this. Because air energy is our thoughts, our words. It's what, how we communicate, which is totally explains it. Now, seeing the beauty in everything, okay? The sun is illuminating these things, okay? It is illuminating these things with these things, which to me is talking a lot about creative diversity, okay? With the sun having Cancer, which is about nurturing yourself so we can nurture others, showing compassion, and also Aries energy is about who you are, about your own self-evolvement, your own, your will and what drives you. And it's actually feminine and masculine too, actually. Aries kind of represents more of the masculine, and Cancer represents the feminine, between nurturing and our true desire, will, our motivation, what drives us. That's pretty cool, actually. And Pisces and Scorpio. Now, with this being water energy, okay, Scorpio is about transformation. And with the moon, this is representing the moon sign. The moon sign reveals emotions and the emotions of our experience. It's our heart center. It's like the key. The moon energy is like the key to creating fulfillment, to creating whatever it is that your heart's desire. I mean, it's like our emotions drive our perceptions and our reality, which is our experience, okay? So, it's about, it also is key, and it is heart-centered, because it's about our memories, okay? Our learned patterns, our skills and abilities and things within our memories, okay? So this is how we create our perceptions and our reality. It's based off of all these things in the moon. And our inner child is also here in the moon aspect, because all of these things, which on this side with these coming out, the bully and the guide, these things within our inner child, when they get wounded, and the shadow starts to protect the inner child, okay? The ego that's protecting the shadow. The ego is actually a good thing. It's not a bad thing. The ego is there for a reason. The ego is very important. Now, when we have a lot of shadow things going on and a lot of rejection within us, is where sometimes it can get out of control, okay? So, now, with the tower, I'm going to talk back. I need to get back on track a little bit. But with the tower, okay, coming into the persona, which talks about a significant life event, powerful revelation leading to change, it's time to spread our wings, okay? Where with the self, we have the transformation card, the death card, which is about release. It's the end of the phase or situation. It's a spiritual transformation. It's time to move on. So with the artist talking about revelations leading to change after events happening, spread your wings, be you. What are you, like, who, what do you have to contribute as far as artistically to the world? Are you great with your hands? Are you a sculptor? Are you a photographer? Are you a landscaper, a painter? Are you a craftsman? There's so many things. Are you a musician? I mean, artists, everybody is an artist in some aspect of themselves. And when you really go back into and get in tune with your inner child, that's where you'll find where your true inner artist is. And that is part of who you are and your inner prosperity. And with the poet of the self talking about finding beauty in everything, okay? To me, this is talking about with creative diversity. And this is talking about the end of a phase or situation. Transformation. It's time to move on. Stop looking at things negatively, is what this says, is what I see out of this. Stop hiding things within yourself and seeing the world as an ugly thing, or stop judging and such, and start letting a transition happen and enjoy and embrace the differences in the world, the creativeness, and instead of looking at diversity as, you know, dividing humanity of what they share as humans, diversity as creativity of enjoying and seeing the beauty and what other people have to offer. That is diversity. Self-expression and any kind of expression between the poet and an artist, okay? Planting seeds. We're now with the moon, with the bully and the guide, and this is about sweetness of suffering and karmic relationships and how to change this around, which is the juggling of it. It's just, it doesn't work, because these things, both of these situations, where when we put financial gain and stuff over our own happiness, you know, when we choose something because, you know, cost of living and such, and making decisions on how we're going to raise our kids and how, what we're going to teach us, you know, what's important in life. Financial situations, yes, you need money to live, right? Well, when you also, and when we talk about, you know, money doesn't create happiness, that is true. Money can make things easier to find things you enjoy, but if you are not actually lighting up with your own actual artistic things and seeing beauty and enjoying what you do, money isn't going to do anything for you. You're not going to be happy. It's about knowing that the inner happiness is the only way that money is actually going to do anything for you. Because if you're just miserable and you're putting money above any part of your happiness, you're not going to enjoy it. You're constantly searching, constantly. And that creates also more shadows where you start putting down other people for, you know, and that's where jealousy and bitterness and resentment comes into play. Often, then we start bullying, just like the shadow here. It's about where we're concealing our deep fears behind, you know, lashing out at people. And instead of facing those fears within ourselves and overcoming things, we start projecting and doing on others what was done onto us, and that isn't ultimately doing anything fulfilling. It's creating more karmic relationships, and it's creating the sweetness of suffering. But is it really sweet? No. But we are like sometimes projecting things and going on as if we're normalizing this. And it's just, it's become our pattern. It's become our habits, our instincts. That's naturally, and we start embodying this and teaching our children and leaving on legacies of that. When we can switch things around. Now the Empress is representing the bully, which is about lavish abundance. Give birth to your dreams, nurture yourself and others, which I think is perfect with this, because it's about, you know, not intimidating others. Confront your inner fears, nurture yourself to confront your fears, give yourself the self-love you need to heal. Concealing deep fears behind verbal abuse, which just means you're just projecting and you're taking out on others things within your own pain. The Empress is perfect to come out for this, because after you have to nurture yourself to heal before you can turn around and become that and nurture others. Where here with the Dreamer, which is the Fool card under the guide, it's about a leap of faith. Follow your dreams. Unexpected opportunities will come. That represents follow your dreams and abundance will come. The money will follow. Things don't chase your, you know, whatever we do for our career, that is what we spend our, that represents us. That's what we manifest as us into the world. And if you're just manifesting and picking a career because you want to make money, but you're not actually doing something that fulfills you, that makes you feel good about yourself, or makes you, or something that you enjoy, you're miserable. You're miserable. And if you just, you know, you pick things that you know, find what you actually enjoy, and that doesn't mean, you know, well, I enjoy, you know, not everybody can be a musician and not, but the thing is, when you look at the beauty in the world and you stop seeing, you know, things as black and white, you can start to see how you can find your passions of things that you're good at and you enjoy and part of your inner child thing. And it doesn't have to be like childlike. You can see the beauty and how creative diversity creates things to where you can innovate it, create something out of it. And that is possible. It's only not possible when we close our mind to these things and cut off our, if we're not balanced between our feminine and masculine within us, we're either too structured or we're too like intuitive and or too creative. And you need to balance your structure and your creativity. And to me, that's what this is talking about. And you know, it's, you don't want to get your head in your clouds too much, right? And that's exactly what Pisces energy is sometimes. It's about, the thing about Pisces, it's the last part of the zodiac. It's the last sign, 12th house. And that's about embodying lessons you've learned and embodying and looking at things and reflecting and seeing the lessons and all that, and seeing exactly how things should go about and change and how to create, you know, how to see things through your free will. Because free will is breaking out of this. Free will is breaking out of this and not being led by your shadow, by the rejectedness and projecting that onto others. Free will is changing that, which is leading to creative diversity. This reading is turning out perfect. This is, wow. Now, and the sun, and this is also representing the opportunities and stepping into the new, okay? That's what's being illuminated by the moon, which is about polarity balancing and about seeing through illusions and seeing through blockages and utilizing, you know, your intentions, knowing what your intentions are and knowing what others' intentions are, okay? And that's about not being judgmental and understanding, okay? So that's what this illumination is about, and that's what this is bringing. And to me, this is about demise of the hierarchy, which is about submissive and controlling, which, and about planting seeds with your intentions to not feel stuck and not be restless, okay? And the root chakra and the heart chakra is what's being played in here. And the root chakra is our sense of safety, our survival instinct, okay? Where heart chakra is about compassion and love. So this, that, it's totally fear and love. And conquering fear with love, because fear creates bitterness, resentment, hate, jealousy, all the wrong intentions. When you talk about changing that into love-based, that's about when you give yourself nurturing and you do what's right for you. And that means for you, not anybody else. And that part of this is all about doing what's right for you and cleaning and clearing out your own self is what this is illuminating. And it just naturally turns around. And then you do things based off of joy and prosperity and excitement for people, and you really start, you know, you understand compassion, and you look at people with more beauty in your eyes. You don't look at the ugly and everything. You see the beauty, and that is from the inside out, 100%. Seeing the beauty in the world is seeing the beauty from the inside out, and it start, and the inside out means it starts with you. Doesn't mean looking at somebody else's beauty from the inside out and seeing their outer beauty from the inner beauty. No, beauty from the inside out means seeing the beauty in things, embodying it, becoming it. It starts with working on yourself, because when you get the beauty within yourself inside handled and straightened out, your world around you, you start to see the beauty outside of you. That's the beauty from the inside out. You start within yourself, and it radiates, and it will manifest, and it will prosper. The outside world, your reality will change from the inside out with true beauty from the inside out. Now, with the dominant energy, when I pulled the ancestor, the angels and ancestor oracle cards, we have the Father Sky, the dominant energy, and what's being shown is the broken arrow. The Stargazer is how to shift things moving forward. The She-Wolf is what we're learning and lessons that we're gathering. And the Magic Guardian is the how we're ready to move forward. And this Father Sky represents opportunity, okay, which is the dominant energy. It's about coordinating your life. It's about trusting in the unknown and masculine energies, okay? What we're being shown, the broken arrow, is about releasing victim mentality. It's about putting defenses down, embracing the energy of peace, okay, and knowing that you are safe. It's what we're being shown. We are safe. The illusion of the fear-based things, it's an illusion. It's an illusion, because ultimately, at the end of the day, fear is an illusion. It's something that is put in our mind, seeds planted for the wrong reasons. It's always, it's seeds planted with the wrong reasons, the wrong intentions. Now, how to shift moving forward, Stargazer. Set your sights higher. The impossible is possible. Focus on your vision. Focus on your vision means what is meaningful to you? What do you want? What do you enjoy? What do you love? Okay? Now, with, the what we're learning, the lessons we're gathering, the She-Wolf, it's about unleashing the wild within you, expressing your true self. What's your talents? What's your desires? That's what we've learned, what we're gathering to be able to move forward, and how we know we're ready to move forward. It's about the Magic Guardian. Unlock the magic within you. This is about acknowledging your intentions that you create. Acknowledging what you send out. Acknowledge and be aware. What is it that you're sending out into the world? What is it that's leading you with your actions, with your decisions, with your wants, with your decision making, with your the way you do things and talk to people and look at people? What is it? What's your intentions? What intentions are leading you? Okay, that's very important, and that is how we're ready to move forward. We are very capable of acknowledging that and understanding that and doing that. That's part of being human. That's the beginning of world peace right there, because seeing beauty from the inside out, starting with yourself, that's the way to change everything. Now, we had clarifying the Father Sky, which is the masculine energies, was the Empress, which I thought that's perfect, because that's about nurturing. And that is perfect for masculine, feminine, okay? Masculine energies, Father Sky, Father God, and Mother Goddess. Basically, the Empress embodies all of the queen energy, right? Which is the feminine, which is represents creativity. And remember, we have all of this within us. It isn't separated. It isn't men and women separated. It isn't masculine and feminine separated, because it is within all of us. That's what creative diversity is all about. Okay? And with the what we're being shown with the broken arrow, releasing victim mentality, okay, defense is down, you are safe. The King of Pentacles, the King of Earth, that's what is coming out to clarify this, which the King of Earth, the King is about structure, earth energy, manifesting. The King in the tarot represents knowing what's best, doing what's right for everyone involved, not just yourself. That the best type of king to have is the king who stands alongside of his kingdom. Okay, the King of Earth, the King of Pentacles, the King of Earth is being who you say you are, leading by example. Best king is a leader, not someone who just tells people what to do. A good leader does what they tell you to do, leads by example, shows you, embodies it. They lead by example. I mean, I don't even know what else to say to that. And with earth energy, that's about manifesting, creating our reality, because earth energy is the reality. It is what we have around us, our environment, all of that. We create that. Lead by example. Release your victim mentality is how I was saying. Put your defensives down. Know you're safe. Create something. This is what we're being shown. The Stargazer, okay, is how to shift things moving forward. Set your sights higher. We have the Magician. The Magician. The Magician is here to represent this. The Stargazer. Focus your vision. The impossible is possible. Set your sights higher. Use what you know, what you have. You have everything you need. We have everything I need. We need. We all do. This is what the Magician is saying. How are you going to use what you have to set your intentions correctly? To you know how you can stop yourself when you can. And this also, know that this means that when I talk about knowing what intentions you send out, think about that. Know that you're gonna mess up. You're gonna mess up. That's a given. No one just catches on right away. But the whole purpose is, when you're doing this, when you catch yourself, start stopping yourself when you can. Or make wrong, right your wrongs. Apologize. Own up to it. Own it. Take accountability for the things that you do wrong. That's the most important thing, because that is how you lead by example, and that's how you start to progress and embody things. You start to progressively change things little by little. You're like, man, I did this, okay, I'm gonna work on it, and actually do it, mean what you say, because eventually you'll start catching yourself in the middle of a trigger, right in the middle of it, eventually. Now, not at first you won't, but as you keep going, you'll be able to be like, what am I doing, and you'll be able to stop yourself in the middle of a trigger. It does progress to that, when you get to that, when you're consciously working on it, that does happen, and you can, that's how you make changes, that's how, and I'm not going to get into that too much right now, that's a whole other topic, but it is possible. I just wanted to mention that, okay? Now, with the She-Wolf, which is what we've learned, the lessons we're gathering, which is unleashing the wild within, express your true self, your talents, your desires, the Four of Water, okay? This is the Four of Cups. Now, remember, look, and we have all this water energy right now going on, okay? Water brings the new. The Four of Cups is about meditating, about going within, okay? And looking around and seeing, are you missing opportunities? Is there opportunities that you're letting pass you by because you're not interested, or because you're afraid, or you know, really, really reflect over things for your, or also the number four represents foundations as well, and stability and creating things, and stability, okay, like house or walls in a room, and you know, expressing yourself. It's about looking at the opportunities you have and utilizing them. And also, you know, what's your talents and your desires? You've got to go in and reflect. You have to look at your memories, your emotions, know what's driving you. OK, Okay, but that only way to figure those things out, to be able to undo the clutter within that keeps us from that, you have to go within yourself and find it. No one else can tell you how to do it. It's something that you have to be able to do within yourself. And it's also about when we are, I'm trying to think of how to say this. Everything that you need, there is nothing new that you need to pick up, because your talents and your desires, they are in within you already. There's clutter covering them up, clutter, and it's you to go within and unclutter and take out things that don't belong to you and things that really aren't you and things that, you know, like with the bullying and that. And such, from the shadow and the duality dynamic of, you know, what drives us. Undoing things that we do for the wrong reasons. First, you have to unclutter all those things to be able to get underneath and find your true heart's desire. What it is that you can want, that you enjoy, that you want, who you are, who you are proud to represent yourself as, and feel fulfilled from the inside out. Now, with how we're ready to move forward, the Magic Guardian, and it is... clarified that the Six of Air, which is the Six of Swords as well, which is about moving on. And this ship is perfect. The ship is moving on. And as you see, the seagull, the ship is floating in the air. It's moving on to new things. Okay? And it's about acknowledging your intentions and what you create. That's unlocking the magic within you. Because that's about your free will. That's about your free will. Okay, acknowledging and utilizing your intentions correctly is about creating your reality for you the way you choose, without the shadow aspect hindering, without any, you know, conditioning or doubts within and stuff. It's about healing. Okay, moving on to new and better things. Set your sights higher. Okay, it is possible. See through the illusion. Move out of the illusion. That's how I feel that this is what this is talking about. I think I'm gonna end this here. I think it might, Yeah, I think that's a good place to end the reading. Let's see. Well, I might. I'm going to unexpected and expected. I'm going to pull an oracle card for not that. Let's see. What we've learned and how we're ready to move forward. Okay, this is like an inspiration card. Like advice on how to move forward. Two cards for what we're learning and how to move forward. I'm going to pull two cards. To move forward. Just split this. We have motivation and attitude. Okay? So what we're learning and how to move forward. What we're learning about motivation and how to move forward, attitude. What we're learning, we're motivated. I am motivated, and motivated people help me to improve my finances. Okay, this is what we're learning and how to move forward. Attitude. I attract success and positive people into my life with my positive attitude. This totally, they coincide, they go hand in hand, and it's perfect for this reading. because it's about following your true heart's desire, embracing creative diversity, embrace the inner child within and find that and create something, and that brings your wealth, enjoy your money by creating it, doing what you love, or creating something, or don't make your decisions on what to do, who you are going to be, based off of just money if it's something that's not actually something that you enjoy. There's a lot of things that we enjoy, you know, there isn't just one or two things, but making the decision based on that, and know that it will come, and you're motivated, and motivated people help you improve your finances. Attract success and positive people into your life with a positive attitude. Wow. Wow. That's pretty cool. Okay, I'm going to end the reading there. Thank you.